The latest attack by Hamas has shown the limits of Israel's defensive systems, including the Iron Dome. While Iron Dome has been able to intercept many incoming rockets, the platform at several points during this conflict seems to have been overwhelmed. A new system holds the key to the future of defensive cover for Israel, Iron Beam. The laser weapon is designed to defend against different kinds of projectiles that are launched towards Israel by knocking them out of the air. It will complement the country's existing layered air defense, which consists of several air defense systems like Iron Dome and Arrow. According to some reports, this weapon system is set to see its accelerated deployment in response to the current situation. The system, originally anticipated to be operational in a few years, will serve as the short-range component of the Israeli Integrated Missile Defense System. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Iron Beam is critical for Israel. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Israel's been targeted by different kinds of projectiles, like short-range rockets, artillery fire, and mortars. In 2011, Israel began operating the Iron Dome officially. It has a very impressive success rate, but has its limitations. Each Tamir interceptor used by Iron Dome is thought to cost $80,000. The rockets fired by Hamas would be $1,000 to $1,200 each at max. If Hamas fires a large number of rockets in a coordinated manner, like it has done this time, it's untenable for Israel to keep intercepting them with the very costly Tamir interceptor. Also, the interceptor being state-of-the-art needs precision manufacturing, which is a time-consuming process and hence can't be replenished easily. Iron Beam uses a fiber laser to generate a laser beam to destroy an airborne target. Whether acting as a standalone system or with external cueing as part of an air defense system, a threat is detected by a surveillance system and tracked by vehicle platforms in order to engage. The head of the Defense Ministry's Weapons Development Administration, Brigadier General Yaniv Rotem, said in 2020, "We are entering a new era of energy combat in the air, on land, and at sea. Investments by the Defense Ministry in recent years have positioned Israel among the leading countries in the field of high-power lasers. As per reports, Israel has actually been working on this kind of laser technology for years. However, significant progress was made in a collaborative effort involving Israel's Defense Ministry, Israeli defense firms, Rafael Advanced Defense Systems, Elbit Systems, and members of their academic community. Reports indicate that a breakthrough in the Israeli effort came about 3 years ago. The Israeli team of scientists and engineers was able to create a technology to focus and stabilize the laser beams over distances and overcome atmospheric disturbance. This led to the development of effective interception technology. Lasers are concentrated beams of light that transmit large amounts of electromagnetic radiation against their targets. The power of a laser is generally stated in kilowatts. The general idea of laser beam weaponry is to hit a target with a train of brief pulses of light. The rapid evaporation and expansion of the surface cause shock waves that damage the target. When a laser beam strikes a target, it can cause the external surface to heat up rapidly, This can cause a drone, a rocket, or a shell to burst in the sky. Lasers have some very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. This is pretty significant, as traditional air defense systems can run out of ammunition when encountering a large number of incoming threats. They're silent and invisible, which makes them very much suitable for use in urban landscape. They're also so much cheaper. The new system could cost as low as $3.50 per interception. This is very cost-effective compared to conventional interception systems like Iron Dome. Laser weapon systems have a major limitation of operation in low visibility conditions like cloud, fog, dust, haze storms, smoke screens, and rain, since laser beams comprise of light waves. These are restricted to line-of-sight engagements. Atmospheric disturbances also scatter the beam. However, Israeli experts seem to have overcome many of the challenges. In April 2022, the Israeli Ministry of Defense and Rafael announced that in a series of experiments, the system successfully shot down drones, rockets, mortar bombs, and anti-tank missiles. The then Prime Minister Naftali Bennett said in February 2022 that Israel would deploy the system within the year. However, in October 2022, Rafael said it expects to take 2 to 3 years to deploy the 100-kilowatt weapon operationally. Israel's expertise in developing air defense systems is well known. A preemptive strike with accurate intelligence on Hamas is one way to make sure the group is unable to amass such a large quantity of rockets. But as clear from the latest attack, it will not be possible every time. There is a need for a system that can complement the Iron Dome. The Israeli laser-based interceptor system appears to be a class above, and if it works as stated, it will be a quantum leap. A system like this could potentially be installed on land, sea, and aerial platforms in the future. Apart from acting as a counter-rocket, artillery, and mortar solution, the system could be possibly used against drone swarms and hypersonic weapons going forward. Reports indicate that even before this Hamas attack, the military pushed for an earlier deployment, possibly due to concerns that there would not be sufficient Iron Dome interceptors to combat attacks. It remains to be seen how fast Israel can manage to deploy it operationally.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.